up over the top towards Carrow Moor. Now a very bumpy section all the way to Ramsey. A very difficult sequence, very bumpy. Then over the jump on the exit above Lendo. Just past the 21 mile marker. Hard on the brakes approaching Glen Tranmere. To a right-hander, severe adverse camber. That's 22 miles. A bumpy right-hander into Milltown. Very bumpy just before this one. The right-hander going in is practically ahead. Really bumpy on the way out of this one. A sweeping right-hander. Past 24 miles. The left into Whitegate. Another second gear corner. A real short circuit corner. Just before the hairpin. Takes a lot of stopping because it's very tight. A slowish right and then a slower right. Five fast corners in rapid succession. At the 25 mile marker. Gooseneck is like a short circuit corner, really. You need a good line through all these fast corners. On Guthrie's, there's three left-handers. After this, you try to get your head down the mountain mile. We're 27 miles around the course. Flat out in top gear along here. This is where the clock comes down. First real chance to relax a bit, it's still been quite a long section. It's supposed to be a straight. But on the big superbikes, those bends become a lot bigger. Passing the 28 mile mark. Passing the three-quarter way post. They need to watch out for those crosswinds. Just past the 29 mile mark. There's a fair dip going past the hut. A long left approaching the veranda. You take these four right-handers as one, you get it right. Then the 30 mile mark. Treat this one with a lot of caution. Across the railway lines. under the footbridge, then hard on the gas. Named in memory of the late, great Mike Hailwood. Top gear as you head towards Brandywell. This one's tighter than you think. Fast left-hander. Just before the 32-mile mark. At the 32-mile mark. It's not called Windy Corner for nothing. Down towards the steep hill, down towards the crag, at the 34-mile point. Hard on the brakes into the crag. Probably the best spectating spot outside of Douglas. People have been clocked at over 195 miles per hour down here on the big bikes. Just before hard braking into Brandish. Named after Walter Brandish, who broke his leg here in practice for the 1923 TT, which ended his racing career. Fast right-hand exit. A multiple left-hander. Have to watch for the dip on the exit of this one. Second gear round here. A very slow, tight bend. Then dive down the hill to the dead step. This looks easy on the approach, but it's a blind bend. Give it just a bit of gas down towards the nook. Down lots of gears. Don't want to do something foolish around this one. Really get the power on after this. On to the start-finish line. Back down Glen Country Road. Past the grandstand.